I'm at this incredible off-grid tiny cabin at the top of a mountain in North Carolina today. This Airbnb owner has over 100 acres of land on top of this mountain. You can already see some of these incredible sprawling views behind me. And this tiny cabin is truly off-grid. It's the perfect place to disconnect. It also has one amazing amenity. It has this gigantic swing, and you can take it out and swing right over the mountain. It is so much fun. I cannot wait for you guys just to see everything that this Airbnb has to offer. So without further ado, let's now hop right into the tour. To get the ball rolling, we're going to pull up in our car right next to the cabin and exit the vehicle. And here she is. Here is your off-grid tiny cabin right on top of the mountain. This is the back exterior. I'll get to the other side and obviously do a full tour of the interior in just a second. You can already see a nice little sneak peek of the mountains in the background. First up though, I'll cover some of the nearby amenities, starting with this hammock, which is right behind the cabin. It's very comfortable and relaxing. Then just a 60-second walk away from the cabin is your own private and very secluded fire pit. You have two chairs there and a few other logs that can be used as tables. This is definitely an ideal setting to spend some time with your loved ones. But now on to by far my favorite exterior amenity. It's this epic two-person swing. It's anchored about 50 feet up in the trees, and you can swing about another 20 feet out into the mountains. And it's just such an exhilarating feeling. I feel like a kid again. I mean, just look at this point of view shot. It's just so much fun. I was there for a long time, and honestly, I would book this cabin just for the swing alone. It was like that special and one of the coolest amenities I've ever had at an Airbnb before. And just look at this view. When I just pulled back with my drone and I saw this view for the first time, my jaw just dropped. So highly suggest you book this place, if not for anything, just for this swing. Now, back to the cabin. Let's go now and approach the cabin. That will do it for all the main exterior amenities. So we're gonna walk on up here. I have all of my bags, open up this little gate. And if we then round the corner, we'll come to the main front exterior. And here she is. This is your 100 square foot tiny off-grid cabin. You can kind of see it's split up into two parts. On the left, that is the main bedroom area. And on the right, they just recently added in a bathroom. I'll start first with the deck though. Just look at how epic these views are. I'll get to them more very shortly. This is just the perfect setting though, I think, to start your day with a morning cup of coffee. You have two chairs as well. This is definitely meant for a couple, I think, and it's even pet friendly. So yes, you can bring your pet with you. You have these screens then as well over the main door. You can pull them down and it's great to keep the insects out. I'm sure it's a question you might have for up here in the mountains. You can even button them up really tightly against the wall to make sure nothing gets in. This gives you a better aerial perspective on how the entire deck is laid out. But now I'm going to quickly switch gears just to show off more the location of this cabin. You are directly looking out into these mountains, and every morning you can just get out of bed, stroll on over to the front railing of your deck, and this is the location of this cabin. Just wow. It is about as high up in the mountains in North Carolina as you can get. Again, over 100 acres that this Airbnb host has, and all of your nearest neighbors are at the bottom of the mountain. It's very private and very secluded. That will do it for the exterior. We're going to now walk through this door and finally come on inside. Welcome to the interior. On the left is the door we just came through. Straight ahead is the bed, and the kitchenette is on the right. There's a lot to cover there. There's also a large garage door here. So in addition to those screens, you can also close this for some more privacy. To get the ball rolling on the interior, you have that large bed in the middle. Again, I think it's perfect for couples. That's definitely the most typical type of guests that rent out this space. But in particular, I really love that headboard right behind the bed. I thought it matched the area perfectly, and it's very similar to the kitchenette counter. In this corner near the door, you have some storage space in your heater. The temperature may drop a lot at night when you're there, so I suggest reading this guest book right here. It has lots of helpful and detailed instructions. Then down below, you have some more games and some books for entertainment. So lots of great stuff over here in this area. On the other side of the door, you have some extra chairs and a little table, some towel racks. And if you open up this little cupboard right here, you have a mirror you can get ready in front of. There's even some notes and some initials from past guests, which I think is pretty cool. But they really used every square inch of this interior space. Last but not least, against this far wall, you have your kitchenette. I think it's very well stocked, especially considering you only have about 100 square feet of interior space in this tiny cabin. Starting first over here on the left-hand side, you have a little sink and then a big jug of clean drinking water. And as you pan more to the right, you have some necessities like paper towels, salt, pepper. You have that little tea kettle in your stovetop. And above all that, you have some kitchen knives and more supplies. Now, directly below the main countertop area, you have two shelves with plenty of pots and pans. So you really have a lot of stuff here if you do want to cook during your stay. The top shelf then features some more cups, some mugs, and perhaps the most important feature of this entire area is definitely your generator. So again, we are 100% off-grid, but if you need to charge up your phone or your laptop like I'm doing right here, I had to back up some footage that is available to use. You can still charge your electronics. That will do it for this area. Let's now exit this main room as there's still one more spot that I need to show you all. I'm sure you may be asking by now, well, Mike, where do I go to the bathroom? Where do I take a shower? Those are great questions. Over here on the right side of the exterior, there are two areas. Starting first here, you can take your shower here by standing in that little tub. Then that is actually a solar shower, so you can use the sun's rays to heat up your water. Then over here on the far end, this is your outhouse. It's very clean and it has everything you need. And I mean, hey, to be honest, I honestly couldn't think of having a much better view while you're going to the bathroom. It's all very private, absolutely no one can see you while you're doing your business. Thanks for checking out my video tour, guys. I do want to quickly mention the Airbnb host has a few cabins in case the one that we just toured is booked because it's very popular. They have a container home and two other cabins, and they actually just very recently launched their brand new A-frame. If you enjoyed today's video tour, please give the video a thumbs up and make sure to subscribe to the channel. Those are the two best ways you can support me if you're new here. I also have a tiny home playlist linked in the video description. I've toured over a dozen other tiny spaces like this one today, so go and check that out. Thanks so much again for watching, guys, and I'll see you next week for a brand new Airbnb tour.